Now that we've learned how to rig an arm, both with separated layers and with puppet pins, now it's time to try to rig an entire character. We need to separate the artwork of the character as shown in the animation. Make sure each part of the character is on a different layer and labeled with the file names that DUIK uses. Then, import the file. Make sure to import it as composition retain layer sizes. Double-click on the composition. Now we have our composition and we have different layers. Notice on the face, it is made up of multiple pieces. Before we start, select all of the layers of the face and then right-click to pre-compose. Label it head. This allows us to enter into the head composition and edit and animate these separately. Before rigging, it is a good idea to lock your artwork layers. That way you do not accidentally move them during the rigging process. Another important step is to change the composition settings so it is easier to see the rigging process. Select a light gray. Now, select Hominoid. DUIK creates all of the structures needed. This is arm. This is leg. This is leg 2. This is arm 2. And this is the spine. You can move them out of the way to make it easier to rig. We will start with the character's right side, starting with the arm. Move the arm to where it pivots. Then select the next piece and put it at the elbow. The next piece goes to the wrist, and then this goes at the fingertips. Now, to make it easier, we can hide the arm tip, the hand, the forearm, and the arm. This makes everything easier to see. Now let's rig the leg. Bring the leg structure to the thigh, then the knee, then the ankle. This piece goes to the ball of the foot. This rotates around to the toes. And then finally, this piece goes to the heel of the foot. This allows for the foot roll in DUIK. Now we can hide all of these structure pieces. Now let's do the left arm. To make it easier to see, we will hide the torso. Unlock the layers and hide torso and hips. Make sure to lock them again. Grab the arm structure and move it into position, starting with the arm. Then move to the elbow, then the wrist. Finally, the tip of the hand. We can hide these structures as well. Next, let's do leg 2. Move it into position, then the knee, then the ankle, and once again, we will move to the ball of the foot, then the toes, and then the heel. Now we can hide all of the leg 2 structures. This leaves us with the spine. We can show our layers. Notice that I have a torso layer and a hips layer. Hips, spine 1, spine 2, neck, and head. Often, it is better to combine techniques, so I'm going to use puppet pins and bones for the torso. Solo the torso layer. Select the puppet pin tool. Here, we need to place a pin for spine, spine 2, and neck. Expand the mesh. Label the puppet pins by pressing Enter. So I have spine, spine 2, and neck. Select all of the puppet pins, then in Links and Constraints, add bones. We can unsolo these layers. We can hide the visibility of the bones after we rig. Lock the two layers. Place the hip structure, then the spine 1 structure, then the spine 2 structure, then the neck, then the head, and the head tip. Now we can hide the spine structures. We can also hide the visibility of the bones, and we can lock the bones. Now all we have to do is parent each of the layers and then auto-rig the character. To do this, use the tilde key to expand your layers. To parent the layers, you need to unlock all of your layers. Use the pick whip tool to parent the layers. The head goes to the head layer. The hand goes to the hand layer. The forearm goes to the forearm layer. The arm goes to the arm layer. The neck bone goes to the neck layer. The spine 2 bone goes to the spine 2 structure. The spine goes to the spine structure. The hips go to the hip structure. We do not need to parent the torso because we made bones. The neck also goes to the neck structure. Hand 2 goes to the hand 2 structure. Forearm 2 goes to the forearm 2 structure. Arm 2 goes to the arm 2 structure. Foot goes to the foot structure. Calf goes to the calf structure. Thigh goes to the thigh structure. Foot 2 goes to the foot 2 structure. Calf 2 goes to the calf 2 structure. And thigh 2 goes to the thigh 2 structure. Now everything is parented, we can relock our layers. While we are here, we want to clean up our timeline by shining all of these layers and structures. Press the tilde key. Now, select all of the structures. Shift-click to select, then click Auto-Rig. DUIK creates controllers. Click the triangles to make the controllers collapse. Then press the tilde key to expand the layers, and we will lock all of our structures so we don't move them accidentally. Then click the Shy button to shy your layers. Press the tilde key again. Now we can select all of our layers. Press P, then Shift R. Notice that the rotation values are at 0, but the position values are very hard to remember. We can fix this by clicking on the 0 button. Now DUIK has created null objects and parented each controller to that null object. Now to get back to a neutral position, we can just type 0, 0. We zoom in. We can now click on the controllers to see if our rig works. Notice here that the rig is backwards. Press Command Z, then in the Effects panel, uncheck Reverse. Now the hand moves as it should. Check the other arm. Okay, now we will check the legs. That's good. And that's good. Now we can select all of the controllers, click Automations, and Walk Cycle. Move out to 2 seconds. Make the work area slower. And as you can see, the character is walking backwards. To fix this, go to Main Parameters, Walk Cycle, and change the speed to a positive value. And now your character will walk forwards. We will talk more about the automatic walk cycle in future videos, as well as how to clean up the character. For example, at the elbow here, we could position the structures more accurately.